Someone need to fix their own air on their car. Hi Matt, how you doing? So my normal rod's out today, but I've got some new toys with me. It's only gonna be a short session today. Hi Bella, how you doing? Hi Leah. Hello Bella. So I've just been out and bought some line. Don't know why I'm showing backwards, but it is. Some adrenaline line. Some little toys. Hi Miss Wartside. Got some little toys, so let's get these tied on and see what we can find before it gets dark. Don't know why that's reading backwards, which is strange, but nothing I can do about that right now. How you doing, Sammy? So I think I'm gonna go for one of these to start with, because they look pretty realistic to a rod or a perch. Hi Peter, how you doing? We'll get one of these open. This is what they look like out of the packet. Little focus. Right, spin it round. One of them, which I think look pretty good and look like a little roach. Or a little rudd. Got your main hook on the top there and you've got a little treble underneath. And the waggly tail. So they're a swim bait. So let's get one of them out there and see what that can do. So I've got my new line now as well, so should be able to cast nicely. So I'm all rigged up, I'm just going to clip this on and we'll start fishing. Hi Caroline, how you doing? Oh, while you're on Caroline, I don't know, when we spoke last time you said about putting a donation through the PayPal. If you did, that didn't come through, I was going somewhere else. So I'll just check in with you. No problem if you didn't. Ow, I'm hooking myself just trying to get this on. So basically with it on, it's looking like so. I've got a swivel with a bit of string tubing so I can spin around and do what it needs to do in the water. 28 pound braid, down to another bit of string tubing and a swivel. And that's enough just to stop the pike's teeth from biting through the line. And away we go. So let's see what we can do. Well, that was good. I just saw a pike in front of me down in the swim. That's good. Weren't big, but at least there's fish down there. I actually spooked it, which is a bit of a shame. It was literally just down in front of me. skin, was that? Well, the lure seems to be swimming nice and well in the water. Neville J, how you doing? Hi Donna. Terrible at fishing, how you doing? How you doing, Keith? No, I haven't got any lures, if that's what you're saying. Big pike came out from that spot the other day on a dead bait, yeah? Nice one, Neville. Let's have a little wander along and see if we can find one then. But you can now get through the gate again. Whereas before, that was shut off and you weren't allowed down here. I've never actually been down this bit before. So, there's a gap in the boats just down here. Looks like a nice spot. I could have a few casts from here into the gaps over there. I think I will actually do that. So I've got every chance of finding a nice perch as well as a pike, which is why these areas are nice places to fish. A little bit of what I'm doing. expect them to be sitting over there. See anyone else about? Some points of points about. Some people down the side of the bridge. Stay in the spots too long because I ain't got too long before I start. So give them a few cast feed. Covers most of the water I can. And then just keep moving to the next spot. Right, next one. Use the mullet lures. How you doing, Lee? Yeah, the mullet lures, I did think about that. That's what I have been catching on recently until I lost my favourite one. But I do like the look of these little roachy, ruddy type things. Surely they should be able to do the job. Straight behind the boat over there, lovely. Everyone always say to me that these little lures are too small and stuff, but every pike I've had in the last 6 weeks have all been on these little lures. They're piked to just under 20 pound, just doing what I'm doing now. Haven't had a perch yet, which I'm surprised about. I think I've had a few takes on the perch. We'll have a couple of casts on this end one. Two people staying in the old chalets and stuff up there. The bits and pieces, so I don't want to intrude on them too much, but we'll come and do these areas at some point with some dead baits and stuff. Sit out a bit while I'm sitting out there fishing on the float as well. How you doing, Nitro? Yeah, everyone says use a big lure, but They don't seem to do it for me. All my fish seem to come on these small ones. Couple of chaps around the corner now emptying their keep nets, but I've had some roach and bream or skimmers. Sure, I'm getting little takes, but they might be a little perch. Move over to the other side there, because I feel more confident over there. But I thought I'd have a go in here first anyway. You catch on curly tails, will you? I have got some other ones with me, but I'm more confident on these ones than I am the other ones. I've got some big lures with me, but don't fancy using them. The paddle tails have definitely been the ones that have been catching me the fish this winter. The only other stuff I've caught on is light bait. Look at that, nice sunset in the background as well.
Lovely. little bit close.
Sorry. Paint out there, there's a lot of weed on the bottom. Lovely sunset over there, as you can see. Hi Pam, how you doing? Vincent, how you doing? Welcome to the channel. Change the lure, or do I just keep working my way around? And so there's a lot of weed on the bottom out there. These are fairly heavy, they're going down quite quick.
Anything
out? Not yet, mate. Only just started, though.
I have one.
And it'll go along there, but.
I have one here yesterday, about 18.
Oh, did you? Oh, nice one.
Yeah. Got a couple of chucks in
going on. Nice. Probably heard that everyone. The chap just saying is he had one here yesterday around £18. Maybe you want to see the size of his lures he's got on, they're about 10 times the size of what I've got. Maybe I should go and get a bigger lure. I've got some in the car. Hi Lunker, how you doing? Hi Leon, cheers for coming in. The camera back, it looks lovely. Hi Stephen W, how you doing? Been asleep, have you? Yeah, chap, you just come past and say that massive lures compared to what I've got. We have got some in there, but if you want to see more, I'll do that. Is that, giving you a sunset? quickly grab a, one of the bigger ones and we'll have a go with a bigger lure, shall we? Take you with me, certainly over here. I don't think anyone's going to run off me rod. Biggest one I got is that one, but that is pretty big. But we could give it a go. Or I got something like that. Rattly one. Hi Barry, how you doing? Or something like that. Which one should we go for? Second one. Don't know which one you're on about now. Carl Quick, I've got a video started. What are you on about? You mean I've uploaded one and that's gone on, then that shouldn't have gone on. You thinking that one, are you? Something like that. Oh, the big girl. Yeah, car one shouldn't be on, Stephen. I started, then I shouldn't have done. 50, I saw that happen. Enough already?
Yeah, no, I'm literally passing on the way home from work.
Couple of casts here.
It's the best way.
On, big lure or?
Yeah, always.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Always
do.
Best way, though. Stop for 5 minutes and you get the fish.
It's yeah.
You're here all day, you don't.
Yeah, exactly.
See you later.
See you later, mate. There with everyone, as you saw, I got tangled up and snapped somehow. I'm going to go on this a little bit lighter. That one's really heavy. Right, so we've got this one on now. Mine is... Chap literally stopped for about 10 minutes. Again. Yeah, he was literally just passing with his gear in the back, I think. I got my line wrapped around my reel and I reeled and that snapped on me. So I had to set up again. keep moving around. How you doing, Gary? Haven't seen you for a little while. How you doing? You missed a lot of fish lately. I've had some nice fish lately. I'll be back on the old sea fishing quite soon now. Where can we go here somewhere? Looks like a good spot to try. Line going everywhere at the moment. not an easy spot there. A bit awkward to stand on that wood and try and cast and let you see what I'm doing. Got loads of boats out for sale now. The season started, you see. No point me having a little cast around there, because I can get around the other side here and cast all the way along there, so I might as well do that. We'll have a few casts from here. Watch the power cables above me. We had a perch take it then. Something over there. I don't know where it be. Rubbish on there. They've got some sort of masking tape or something like that. Don't need that.
And any luck yet?
Nah, not yet, mate.
No. The fella next door to us, we stayed in the lodge, the other one, the brown one stick out there.
Oh yeah?
He had a pike the other day on a 16 up.
Oh what? Oh, I've had of
it. It was a, obviously it's a roach that's took it, then the pike took the roach.
Yeah, I've done that a few times.
He's only on £5 line, he got it in, it's about a 10, 12 pound pike, yeah.
It's alright, isn't it,
yeah?
Yeah, I've had a few in the last sort of 6 weeks or so, up to about £20.
Have you?
I'm getting a few, but...
Yeah.
Only got a few hours here and there in between working at the moment.
So. Yeah, so you just move around.
Yeah.
Have a few minutes here.
Give it a go and keep moving around and
yeah.
Go back
good
to
luck
work
anyway.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
All right.
See you, mate. Let's get in the end of here and have a little look, shall we? Got to make sure we've still got room to cast and stuff. We've got a bit of wind here though, so sorry about that. How you doing, newbie? Haven't seen you for a while. I've been out piking loads lately. Had some alright fish as well. Jade's catfishing, how you doing? Alright, we'll have a go into this yard first. Hey Martin, how you doing, mate? I'm starting to run out of light. Is there any trouble? But I'll keep going until I can't see anymore. Yeah, it's not a problem, newbie. Just saying I ain't seen you back for a little while. We've all got to work and stuff and do other stuff, it's no problem. We're just normally catching, you know, someone else's live or one of mine. Just making sure I've said hello to everyone. Greetings from Chicago. Thanks very much, Jay's for catfishing. Appreciate you coming in. Got a pike and a perch out of Coventry Canal. Nice one. So I had a few out of Stullham a couple of days ago. Didn't manage to find any yesterday, and I ain't found any today yet. But I'm only doing sort of a couple of hours here and there. running out of light quickly, which is not good, but I'm doing my best to carry on. I don't know if you all saw that, but a big old pike just jumped out after the lure, but missed it. Oh, that's annoying. I was then coming up for it. I was coming next to that boat. Up on a boat. Didn't need to do that, especially in the dark. Sorry about that, everyone. The wind caught me line. Nah, Roy didn't go nowhere. Trouble I've got now is you probably can't see me much. I'm not sure where there's any light. I One day, Martin, I'm still saving up. It's not as easy as that though, because I need a couple of 6 foot rods, reels, line, the whole lot for the boat. And then I need a 9 foot spinning rod from the bank. And as you know yourself, they're hundreds of pounds. I just ain't got the spare money right now. Been getting a few super chats and stuff like that, so I've been saving them up. I'm gonna see what I can find on the river side of things. Yeah, in time, Martin. So people have been giving me some super chats and stuff and helping me towards them, but they all cost money, don't they? I could probably buy cheaper ones if I wanted to, but need something half decent. It's not going to snap as soon as I get a £10 pike on it or something. I want something that's actually going to last a little while. And then obviously you want to get nice reels to go with them.
In these little positions with a little spinning rod and that. Playing in amongst all the little boat.
Keep moving, I can't really cast much in between them. There's not much distance to cast them really in. I take it a lot of people can't see me now. Ooh. Yeah, exactly, newbie. That is the trouble, isn't it? I try and buy at least middle of the range, middle to top of the range if I can when I'm buying my gear, just so it lasts a bit. Obviously you've seen me land carp to £20 on this rod without any problems. Carp, pike to £20. Let's have a cast right along there, shall we? That's a better way to fish the boats, isn't it? I'm struggling to see now. I think you can just about see me. But we've only got 10 people in, so maybe you can't. All tangled up, I'm trying to sort it out. With a little side light from the boats. Try another spot on the end of this marina. So if you can't see, just let me know and I'll end the live. Yeah, that is dark one, but I thought you'd still be able to see me, but it's not a problem. Not a problem. I can carry on without the camera on. What I'm going to do is have a few chucks around here and then I'll end it. Right, I'm going to have a few casts around here. don't know what that was all about. Chap just went past in a boat, pitch black. No lights on, no nothing, just crawling down the river. Alright. I'm on the background. People can't see a lot now. I ain't got me lights with me. Don't know who that was, but it just went all the way down there. With no lights on, no nothing, just crawling down there really quietly. It's a lot darker around this side, hence why I went there, but some lovely spots on a river over there. Nearly walked into a cone. So I'm wandering back to the car now. I can't even see where I'm walking. I think there'd be some light ones to get around there. Some light over this side. It's killing my arm holding this tripod. All my gear in the other hand. Red and white lights. I done it. got your bag in the car. Right, so we didn't find any on that short session. We did have a couple of takes, as you saw. We had a pike jump out of water after the lure and missed it. And I'm pretty sure we had a couple of takes of some perch or pike just grabbing the end of the lure and not getting hooked. It's definitely worth coming out and having a little go. It was a bit warmer today. Temperature actually went up to 12 degrees, which I was quite shocked about. But obviously what we've been fishing tonight, it's been what, 6-7 degrees? Which isn't too bad. Definitely starting to get more busy around Wroxham and that again now. Yeah, the boating season, everything's all on underway again. Yeah, I thought I'd just have a little go, Martin. I didn't actually plan on going out fishing, to be honest. I was just popping down the shop to get some new line and a couple of little lures. I thought, well, while I'm down here, gears in the boot, why not have a little go? But as everyone knows, with lure fishing, you don't catch every session. Trot now. We've hooked up to 4 pike and landed 2. I can't complain, we've had some fish. I could get a lot more if I went out in the boat, but these little short sessions, by the time I set the boat and everything up, it wouldn't be no good. Still there then, Miss Waterside. I'll message you in a minute when I come off alive and See how things are going on your end. Fair enough. Wondered how things again. This is one 6:30. If anyone's wondering what we're getting on about, Joe's mum's partner is having quite a serious operation today, so everyone's got their fingers crossed everything goes well and we'll be in recovery soon. Get back, have a hot drink, sandal, and then it'll go from there, really. See what car stuff to do, videos to make. So I'm still going to be busy. Appreciate that. Everyone, that must be boring you now. It's fair enough. I'm not fishing anymore, am I? Just that some people like to see this bit. Thanks, Pam. Cast like you've done out with the lures. The heavy reel, heavy rod. Can't wait till I get the lightweight ones. Long way away from me, Sammy. He was fishing Brighton. Just 5 hours for me. We don't get plates around here. Yeah, I saw him get a few. But there is a few fish moving about around the area. So I'll be giving it a go quite soon. It's the end of season soon anyway, so for the fresh water stuff. Then this way whatsoever, really. Sometimes you get the very lucky odd one, but not really along here. More sort of Felixstowe, Clacton, that up, yeah, that sort of way. But that's sort of 800 miles from me now. Stranger. Same as we don't really get form backs along here or nothing like that either. But if I go around the corner last often down along that way, Shingle Street, Felixstowe, there's loads of them. Your thumbs up, I appreciate that, everyone. Bad going, seeing us quite a short live. Cheers, Stephen. Right, everyone, I'm going to sign this one off. Spin you around. Cheers, everyone, for coming in. Appreciate that. Thanks for coming in. And I'll see you in something else fairly soon, I reckon. What are we saying? 35 thumbs up. I ain't caught up at my end yet. We're still saying 33 at my end. But that'll catch up. So yeah, I'm going to grab a hot chocolate, get myself sorted a bit. Probably going to be doing some work over the unit on the little red Corsa. Like I said, I've got a few little videos I want to make. So I've got plenty to be done. So I'll get on with that and I'll see you all soon. Thanks for coming in. Thanks for all the mods. And I'll see you soon.